are touched by deep magic.
What the universe is doing is it is under the sway of what I call the transcendental object at the end of time. Eschaton is a good word out of theology. It simply means the last thing. Concrescence is the idea of something that grows together. It concresces. It becomes more dense, more connected, more defined in space and time. And when I talk about the transcendental object at the end of time, or the coming of the eschaton, I mean that the process of the human and biological concrescence of intent reaches some kind of maximum. And we are about to take the step out of matter. The planet is on a collision course with the most profound event it's possible to imagine, the freeing of organic life from the chrysalis of matter. An event of cosmic significance and importance is going to occur not far in the future. Are we causing it? No. Can we stop it? No. Can we hurry it? No. It's built in to the structure of matter itself. The laws of physics are evolving to permit greater freedom. Concrescence is the end of the process of becoming. Becoming is not true being. True being exists at the concrescence. Matter and organizational processes are about to make some kind of a leap to a new order of being. And I believe as historical processes intensify, it's reasonable to believe that we are ever closer to the eschaton. Processes are now in play which so totally rewrite the script that the future is exploding in an asymptotic unfoldment into a kind of cultural superspace. Novelty increases as we approach the present moment. The universe you and I are living in is a far more novel and complicated place than the early universe was. Well, some people would say, well, that's just a consequence of the unfolding of developmental processes. But this asks the question, what are developmental processes? Why should the universe have a preference for order over disorder? And the psychedelic experience seems to be the anticipatory experience of this eschaton that we're headed toward. It gets you used to the idea that the world is not what it appears to be, and it gets you used to the idea that the world is somehow animate, intelligent, and proceeding along its own agenda, that is how you get out of linear history. That's how you visit the realm of the ancestors. That's how you travel into the future. That's how you break up the tyranny of Newtonian serial time. History is the shockwave which precedes the eschaton. This is what it's like when a species prepares to depart for the stars. The entire destiny of all life on the planet is tied up in this. We happen to be the point species on a transformation that will affect every living organism on this planet at its conclusion. We must give reverence and credence to nature and nature's methods, because no other methods will allow us to work our way out of the present mess we're in. We are a part of a morphogenetic intent and an unfolding reality that is larger than human understanding. What history is the 25,000 year transition zone. Before you enter the zone, you're an animal. After you leave the zone, you're a god. But for 25,000 years, you're kind of an animal and kind of a god. We can put up with about anything, and it's a good thing because we're going to be tested to the limits, ever closer to the eschaton. If my ideas seem strange to someone, I ask them, can you imagine this planet in 500 years?
Yes.